Starting this bulletin with a major development from India, a Chinese soldier has been arrested by Indian security forces amid heightened tensions between India and China along the line of actual control border. Now, the arrest was made near Demchok area by Indian Army. Indian agencies are probing whether there was any espionage involved. The Chinese soldier has been identified as Corporal Wong Yilong, and as per protocol, after following due procedure, the Chinese soldier will be released soon. Siddhant Sibal, our principal diplomatic correspondent, is joining us live from New Delhi now. Siddhant, thank you so much for joining us. Could you tell us a little bit about this new development?
Well, Ahim, the big development which has comes at a time when both India and China are engaged in sensitive talks. We know that the 8th Corps Commanders meeting is expected to take place very soon. But by and large, this is nothing new in terms of people or soldiers crossing over line of actual control, because that area is not demarcated and these kinds of incidents have happened. In fact, this is the third such incident amidst the standoff between both the armies at the line of actual control. The previous two incidents have happened in Sikkim and in Arunachal Pradesh. In fact, in Arunachal Pradesh, few Chinese cattle had crossed into the Indian territory and India had returned them back. And in Sikkim, we know that three Chinese personnel were found. They were not associated with the PLA, of course. They were returned back by the Indian Army. And this Sikkim incident happened just days after the 29th August development, when India was able to prevent any attempts by the Chinese to occupy the south bank of Pangong Lake. So this time, of course, the difference is that it involves PLA soldiers. Of course, espionage as an angle is something that will be the top focus. We do expect a statement by the Indian Army very soon. We do expect the statement coming in a few hours from now. And as per protocol, usually what happens is that India returns the soldiers, or if they are civilians who have crossed the line of actual control. And in this case also, it looks like a case of confusion by the soldier, but of course coming amidst the tension between both the countries.
Yes, Siddhant, and also, do you think this will have any practical implications on the ongoing peace talks and standoff between India and China?
Well, it's not going to have a major impact, but the fact that it is expected as per protocol that India will allow the soldier to go back, it is a symbolism, it's a sign of positivity. It is something that will be obviously taken in a positive way by the Chinese as well when the soldier will be returned. So in a sense, it will have a certain impact, indirect impact in terms of the positive development around the talks. But by and large, what India wants is a complete de-escalation at the line of actual control. This is still not happening. It has been months now. The standoff started in the month of May. The Galwan incident happened in June. And we know the other developments happened in August and September. But of course, September saw a number of developments, including two high-level in-person engagement by the Indian Foreign Minister and the Defense Minister.
Yes.
The joint statement coming out. Three joint statements have been released by India and China. So, by and large, it is the release will be seen in a positive light by, of course, by the PLA.
All right. All right, Siddhant, thank you so much for joining us with all those details. Moving on now, Thailand's Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha calls for talks with protesters as anti-government.